So I'm going to have to ask you to use your imagination a little bit today, because I'm here at the Hoquiam River, and this is the Lady Grace, except you can't see it. It is a derelict vessel that sunk a couple of years ago and has been stuck in the river ever since. Crews there are working to remove it. They tried to bring it up out of the water today, but they've run into some issues. But that does illustrate the larger problem statewide that derelict vessels pose.
Bubbles were the most we saw of the Lady Grace today as dive teams worked beneath the surface. But that's what brought Commissioner of Public Lands Hillary Franz out to the coast, an often hidden issue.
Boats are abandoned and they're in bad condition and they begin sinking. And obviously it has significant environmental challenges.
The Lady Grace has been a long time problem. Crews hoped to raise it today, but realized the hull was too weak and will take more work. But that's part of the issue, says Franz. The longer these abandoned boats sit, the more expensive removal becomes.
The one behind us has been in here for almost 2 years at least, from the point we identified it, but we haven't had the money to be able to get it out.
Between navigation hazards and the risk of pollution, derelict vessels are in the Department of Natural Resources radar. They've identified at least 204 statewide, 7 in this stretch of river alone. So the agency is asking the legislature to strengthen the derelict vessel removal program to help them address that. They want to remove the spending cap for the vessel turn-in program, start making smaller boats subject to secondary liability, and pilot a vessel recycling program to try and catch these before they get this bad.
Still, I do believe most people would like to voluntarily turn these over and make it efficient and easy versus allow it to cause a problem.
Michael Crow, King 5 News.